Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Perihelion, The Prophecy, or just Perihelion. I think I'm going to start calling it Perihelion. Anyway, we're looking through our character's things. We made 6 characters last episode. Took an hour and a half to make all these guys and research 3 spells each for him, Advent, Rannus, and Runeclaw. Those are our spell casting classes, or psionic power casting classes. And then these are our physical characters: Killdozer, Epsilon, and Twin Snake. Killdozer is a Cybern assassin. Epsilon is a Bionecron knight. Twin Snake is a Symbion mercenary. Runeclaw is a feline chimera psionic. Varanus is a reptilian, or reptilius, or whatever they're calling it, chimera mediator. And Advent is a human anchorite, which is like a cleric, from what I understand. So, we did the psi powers. Movement. I'm not sure, because we can't do anything from here. We have to go to the map. So, I'm not sure what's with this figure here. Equipment we've looked at the end of last episode. Battle. There is no battle going on. Map. Here's the map. After leaving its ageless protective walls, the party casts a final glance back at the Citadel, which has been their silent and calm cradle for centuries before this nightmare has begun. As the wind brings noises of alarm signals and explosions from the distance, you suddenly realize that the Citadel is dying in the ruthless grip of that mysterious dissolving power, which is now obviously sensing you and will spare no effort to pursue you until the end. But presently, you're alone with a sand glider unit in the middle of this desert, totally puzzled and not knowing where to turn. Maybe the only usable information you have is that last file entry on your Netstation. Okay, so area information, area approaching. Abort approaching sequence. You're in the middle of the desert near the Sandstorm Citadel. So I can't click on things to get more. Okay. Guessing that's the Sandstorm Citadel then. And the map just brings us back. Yeah, that's where I just looked. What was it? Movement. Computer network. Personal information. List of files on person. Farewell. Alright. Do I click it or something? Help? Now, when you go on other networks, you have to pay for DIR. Accessing network. List of network commands. Help is this help file. It's actually like a terminal here. Talk is communication. Ask is specified talk. Analyze is item analysis. Scan is organism scan. DIR is directory. Read is access file. Delete file. Log in, connecting, log out, disconnecting, download, store file, and upload, send file. Commands marked with a plus are used to communicate with other net stations. Alright. Log in, log out, download, and upload. Communicate with other net stations. List of network prices. Help is 0. DIR is 50 with log on mode. I think in your own network you don't have to pay for this stuff though. Read is 100, logins 200, upload download is 1,000. Read command requires 50 additional credits for each additional page. DIR command requires 10 additional credits for each file entry. All network services are free of any taxes. We do not take any responsibility for any transaction results. Alright, so it's read that I want to do in the name of that file. Read farewell, or dot, I think it's dot farewell. Extra in-game functions. Tab key, okay, toggles PAL and NTSC mode. Star and plus controls the scroll speed of gameplay messages. Up and down arrow keys skips forward and backward between previously used network commands. Up and down arrow keys, okay. Left mouse button, hold it down to increase the text typing speed of any network procedure. End. End of information. Alright, so we still have, I mean, I think we started out with zero, right? Wait. Read. Unknown command. Read dot. Farewell. Unknown command. What? It told me read, though. Maybe I just type read, and then it... Maybe I type read without that, and it just prompts me without the file name. Please enter file name. Okay. You have to do it like that. Searching. Transmitting. This is the last message I can transmit to you. Remember, you're the only men who cannot be harmed by the unborn directly, but it surely will try to find the way to eliminate you. Now you must go to Midlight. An encrypted netcode to the Emperor is waiting for you there. You must discover it at any cost. Be quick. Forget your doubts and gather all the information you can about that netcode. My fate calls me now. Signed, Commander Pata, Sandstorm Citadel. Is that the guy who, you know, whose eye opened and started talking to the messenger? Is he dead? His fate called him. So we need to go Midlight. I'm going to write this down. I'm going to read through some other things. Midlight. And we... Sorry about that. Encrypted netcode to the Emperor. Okay. Netcode. Is that to talk to the Emperor? Or... is this something the Emperor needs? Does he need that netcode, or is that to just speak with him? Alright. End of information. So I assume we all have this then? Yeah, we all have this farewell message. Okay. Log off, I guess? Unknown command. Exit. Okay. It's exit. Okay. I'm gonna read some stuff. First of all, this thing... I'm not gonna read this out loud because you've heard this in the intro. I read all the things, but only things that aren't voiced. So, the interesting thing is, when you hear this, when you're listening to this, it sounds like the most evil thing that's ever been created is saying this. But it's really a monk, and he's not evil, I think. He sounds very evil. So, it's a monk saw this. And I think this is the prophecy, and because he saw this, and maybe other monks saw it as well after that, that's why they've created these six individuals to fight something like this. And they literally kept in cryonic sleep, or cryogenic sleep, whatever you want to call it, to just fight this thing. And they're resistant to entropy, somehow. Alright, so then this stuff here... Oh, that's not it. Hold on. Okay, this... It shows up. This is the first log that shows up. Messenger's log. Log entry number 11. Now the Sandstorm Citadel is only a few miles ahead, but they are still not responding to my calls on any frequencies. I hear nothing but the whispering of that ice-cold voice in my mind, and I'm not sure I can resist this insane, unbearable pressure any longer. As I behold the threateningly pale sun on the western horizon, I relive again and again all the memories of the past few days since I left the Imperial Sunrise City to accomplish my mission. I witness more pain, suffering, confusion, and horror during my voyage than in my entire life before. This supernatural power, which is now about to cross the border of our world, is much more than evil. It is totally indifferent. Children are dying with twisted mind, torn flesh, and screaming soul without any reason, even without looking into their killer's eyes, because it has no eyes. We have to find a solution. We have to close an unknown door. Hopefully the key lies just ahead. That's why I'm here. Right, so then he arrived at the Citadel. Log entry number 12. The prophecy was born to warn about the potential threat when an apprentice psionic experienced a monumental and perfectly real vision during his meditation training about the unborn. That's the part in the intro I told you. He sounds like the most evil psionic monk ever created. An unbelievably powerful super entity and a gigantic steel fortress built between two dimensions. It was interesting that they chose steel, because steel's an alloy, so who did that? Right? It's iron and something else? A gigantic steel fortress built between two dimensions. Later, this entity was described as one of the primordial forces of the balance, an intelligent manifestation of the entropy, which is capital E, which was ancient even before the birth of the entire universe. Universe capitalized as well. And which is penetrating deeper and deeper into our plane of existence every moment, rushing through different dimensions to swallow up everything in its way. The desperate counter move was called Project Awakening. Six artificial embryos, six children of the most advanced technology, featuring modified, entropy-resistant, genetical, and psychical structure. Six souls to defy a god. Now they lie in timeless cryogenic sleep somewhere in the heart of this citadel, waiting for the day of their awakening. So those are the two messenger logs, and then we have a messenger from, I guess this is the guy Pata we were talking about, Commander's log, last recorded entry. About a week ago, we suddenly lost all our direct conventional, this guy here, Patag, whatever. Lost all our direct conventional and telepathic communication channels between the Citadel and the Emperor, so we expected the visit of an Imperial messenger from the primary zone, but his arrival turned the world upside down. He brought reports from the outside world, very frightening audiovisual and scientific reports about the rapidly decreasing solar activity, horrible genetic distortions among the people, strange energy eruptions on the astral plane, and some unimaginable creatures from an absolutely alien, malevolent dimension. The very last report was actually an order. A cooperative order bearing the mark of the Emperor and the Psionic Council, a definite and unhesitant order to immediately start Project Awakening. All my life I've been persecuted by the fear of this day, and now it becomes reality as the ancient prophecy fulfills itself. A century-long sleep is coming to an end now. time for awakening has come. I like it. The time for awakening has come. Alright. So what is left for us? We have to go to the map. Abort approach. There's nothing interesting here. Okay. Not letting me move. Is it doing the... Oh, it's this, right? Oh, okay. So it's not an open world game. You got a really strange and cold reception at the gates of Watchtower Colony, as the heavily armed guards roughly refuse your request to enter. You decide to leave instead of engaging into a confrontation, but there's obviously something wrong about this place. Those guards were deeply frustrated, or better say, afraid of something yet unknown. Okay, so that's Watchtower there. No, you cannot go that way. You're standing at a southern crossroad. I just want to see what it... Oh. You're staring down into a frightening abyss. Information. The fortified Watchtower Colony lies just ahead of you. Okay. What's that? You're in the middle of the desert near the Sandstorm Citadel. There's nothing interesting. Okay. So we just left the Citadel. You see that in the intro. What's that? You're facing the silent, gaping entrance of the Soul Tomb Mines. Yeah, let's not go to the Soul Tomb Mines just yet. That's another thing there. After climbing up onto the hill, you are now at a small cave entrance. Northern Crossroad. You're at the eastern edge of the Haunted Shade Woods. You're at the foot of Mount Torch. Now, it looks like nothing really happens unless you actually go inside somewhere, so I guess we're free to look around. You have reached the top of this magnificent volcano. I'm going back down. You are near a large crackle at the dark side of Mount Torch. A crackle. You are standing on the dark western side of Mount Torch. Where you stand now is the most abrupt side of Mount Torch. Well, if I go here... Can't go down. The foot of Mount Torch. You're at the top of a rocky cliff above the Flame Pool Lake. Wow, can you really go all these places? You're on the western slope of the Stone Thorn Hills. Climbing onward. You continue climbing onward the Stone Thorn Hills. You're in the eastern side of the Stone Thorn. And go all the way up like that. From this distance, you can feel the mystical aura of Neon's towers. Oh, we worship that god. Or one of us does. Okay, so I think where we want to go is here. You are at the city limits of MidLight. After a short but tiring climb in the rust-colored sand, you finally reach the top of a small dune. As you let your eyes adjust to the eerie sunlight, a majestic sight appears in front of you and immediately takes your breath away. You are facing the ancient city of MidLight, a memento of the vanished past in this decaying, damned present. In a strange mood, you decide to advance towards the once so powerful metropolis, which is nowadays only a haunted shade of itself. The pollution, the crime, and the bio-necron wars were taking their toll. Okay. Are we going to map? You cannot switch to the map while you're on a mission. Alright, movement then. Awesome. I hear that. Very interesting music and sounds. Alright, so I can move like this. Look and interrupt looking. We can use an item, we can open and close doors, we can switch directly to computer network, switch directly to battle. And that's my stuff. Yeah, equipment. So I just click this, or do I have to click that and something else? Alright, we've moved forward. You can barely tell. So just a lot of scenery from what I take it here. Yeah, if you try to walk into a wall, it does that. Interesting, we continue on that way. I don't know if I should be clicking look at every place. You see feasting vultures and rats on the scattered garbage. Dead end, huh? We're heading south at this point. Oops. You're in the main street of MidLight. You can go west or continue north? Let's go north. You see some military units marching towards the evacuated quarters. Where's the evacuated quarters? You have reached the northern zone of MidLight. We can go east or west. Let's go west. So at some point we're gonna run across something. That's not another street or something. Let's go east, I guess. You have reached the northern zone of MidLight. Do you have anything to see here? So we were going east. Let's go south then. Gotta be something around. Or someone. Let's take this. That's north. We can't strafe, huh? South. North. There was another. Yeah. Let's go west from here. Try that. Just down another street, I think, because I was heading east for a little while, but it was on another street, I think. Or maybe I was going the wrong way. So I assume south takes us all the way out. Oh no. Is that west? I don't know if we have to keep looking to the side or if it's something obvious that's gonna show up. Main Street. Right, we came from here. Northern Zone. guys. I don't know what I'm doing. A bunch of signs. I just wish I could read them. Dead end here. A dead end facing east. There's another east. And a north. You're now in the eastern quarter of the city. I know there's stuff to see here. Sorry, guys. Eastern quarter, so if we continue heading east... Can I open that door? No. So from here, head north. So I don't know if I've missed something. These doors don't seem to be able to be opened. Street going west, or we can continue north. And then we can head west from here if you like. Northern zone. Alright, let's go the other way, east. And then... Did that look different? No. So then south, and take that way. I wanted to see if there was a quick way out, and then to go back in. This is the main street. Okay, so I think... east part before. So, let's see. Do you really wish to leave this area? Okay, so this is how we know. Telling it no. Oh, and it turned me around automatically. Okay, so we're heading north. Let's go east right from here. Oh, this city is like way too crowded. I can't deal with this. Still heading east. So we went north, east, now we can go south. I like the way the letters move around for the compass. I know there's stuff to see, I'm just not in the right area, apparently, for anything to be going on. You feel only hopelessness and desperation seeing this doomed town. Okay, so this is a dead end. Facing north. So from here we can go east. East is dead end out. And go north as well, and at that point we end up in the north section of the city, I'm sure. Northern zone. Main Street. So from Main Street we can go north, south, or west. South. Organism detector. Object and network detector. So I'm close to something. Ah! Cool. We found someplace. Anyway, next episode, guys, going inside. I can't believe we've wandered around this city for all this time and finally found somewhere to go in. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.